Technical drills are a big part of coaching. They are used to teach and correct rowing skills. There are many different drills to choose from, and we will show you the ones, in our opinion, that are the most efficient. We group them based on a specific purpose, but many of them can be used for multiple purposes. How you use the drill depends on what you want to achieve. Drills can be very useful, but they can also be overdone. It is important to explain the drills before going out on the water and describe what the drill emphasizes. Poorly executed drills can promote bad habits. For this reason, it is crucial to create optimum conditions for the athletes to be able to do the drills correctly. In most cases, the ability to balance the boat is the limiting factor. We suggest rowing one half of the crew at a time while the other half sets the boat. The most popular drill for this purpose is called pause, body over. Using this drill, we are looking for a clean release of the blade out of the water, easy flow of the hands around the turn, followed by the shoulders. And the athletes should have all of their forward body angle by the pause. Another drill for the same purpose of improving body preparation is rowing with the pause at the finish, hands away. It is quite a mechanical drill because this situation almost never occurs during the regular stroke. It does teach patience in the bow by forcing the body to wait in the bow until the hands go away, but it can also be used to correct bent arms or lack of body swing out of the bow. The pause at half, or at three-quarter slide, stresses finishing the body preparation by a given point on the slide. The pause at three-quarter slide is also used to teach slide control just before the placement of the blade. By stopping the whole motion, with just a quarter of the slide to go, the athletes can be taught to proceed slowly up to the catch. In the drill top quarter slide, we emphasize the easy slide forward, relaxation, and coordination between the hands lifting up, scooping the blades into the water, and stepping on the footboards. The legs only drill is more natural than the top quarter slide drill because it duplicates a larger part of the normal stroke by using the entire slide. We use the same action at the top of the slide as we did in the previous drill, raising the hands and placing the blades in the water as the seat is reaching the top of the slide, followed by direct pressure on the footboards and suspending the body weight on the oar, making the entire leg drive very relaxed and horizontal. The placement drill is used to teach the placement of the blade in the water as part of the recovery. The blade has to be in the water before we put any pressure on the footboards or change the direction of the seat. It starts from the finish position. We are looking for an easy, constant slide speed moving forward and putting the blade in the water precisely as we reach the top of the slide. It is important to control the slide at the very end, otherwise there is a tendency to rush, which will create a very hard and choppy catch. This drill is a little more difficult than the placement drill because of the motion of the boat. The first part of this drill is the placement drill, but it is followed by the drive in the water and ending with a pause at the finish. We have the same slide and same blade placement on the last part of the slide, but now we have to synchronize the entry of the blades into the water with the speed of the boat. The pause at the finish gives a very uniform end to the stroke and a very uniform beginning of the slide moving forward. Be aware that when doing this drill, the athletes tend to rush the slide toward the catch, which will create a choppy catch. We use these drills in a logical sequence. Legs only. Legs and back, followed by regular rowing. Legs only is used to create horizontal hanging on the oar, and it forces the use of the legs at the beginning of the stroke. The extension of the previous drill is legs and back. It reinforces a natural transition of power from the legs to the upper body. Because it is done with the arms locked at the elbows, it forces the athletes to pivot from the hips and extends the hanging on the oars. While doing this drill, the athlete's body swing should send the boat. Rowing with a pause at the finish is a natural extension of the previous drills. It is the legs and back drill with the addition of the arms. It provides an opportunity to practice good blade placement, followed by the patient beginning of the drive with the legs, transitioning to the back, and finishing with the arms. This drill is excellent in helping to develop a uniform power application in bigger boats by using the visible distinction between the first part of the stroke, the very patient and gradual acceleration of the boat, and then the sharp end of the motion. Many top scullers row with this rhythm of the pause at the finish, and while rowing fast, it looks only like a small hesitation at the finish. The sequence of arms only, back and arms, quarter slide, and half slide can have a few different applications. More or less, it teaches the whole stroke, but because the strokes are very short and everything is happening a little faster, it makes the finish of the stroke quicker than normal. For this reason, the sequence is used often to sharpen finishes. Arms only is one of the most basic exercises. The athletes sit at the back of the slide, and the entire stroke is done with the arms. If it is done correctly, with some pressure on the footboards, the blades will rebound out of the water by themselves. Back and arms, sometimes called pick swing drill, teaches coordination between the body swing, arms, and the release of the blades from the water. It can be done on the square or with a feather. The key points are placing the blades in the water, finding resistance, hanging on straight arms at least until the body passes the vertical position, and keeping pressure on the footboards until the blade pops out of the water. Rowing with the paws and the body over is probably the best way to work on the finish of the stroke in terms of the blade work and body motion. It creates a little exaggerated body swing, followed by a solid push of the boat, which then creates a very clean rebound of the blades out of the water. The hands to the gunwale drill is a version of the paws body over drill, with the difference being at the finish where the hands make a very deep circular motion down and away into the boat, and then they stop when they touch the gunwales. This very circular release from the water creates a very patient send of the boat and is helpful teaching a very gradual feathering of the blades out of the water. Rowing square blades is a very good way to improve the blade work at the finish. It forces the athlete to keep pressure on the face of the blade to the last moment. Because the blades are coming out of the water squared, this also teaches the athletes to feather the blades later, after the release from the water. We are using square blades again because it is the best exercise to improve blade work. This drill takes care of every aspect of blade work. It forces a smooth horizontal recovery. It facilitates placement because the blade is already square. And it forces the rower to keep the acceleration at the finish, otherwise the blade will get caught in the moment of the release. It is a great drill because it doesn't need too much coaching and it gives instant feedback to the athletes. This sequence can have multiple purposes. It just depends on what the coach wants to emphasize. First, we are using it to teach how to take the boat on the run. We start with the back and arms, and when the pick of the boat is good and direct, we switch to quarter slide without losing the rhythm at the faster speed. Then we continue this from quarter slide to half slide and so on. We are looking for good slide control followed by a quick change of direction. The blade should be close to the water so they don't miss too much water at the catch. The progression sequence can also be used to teach the end of the stroke. The athlete sits patiently at the end of the stroke, keeping pressure on the footboards to the very last moment. Then push the hands down, releasing this pressure by creating an easy rebound of the blades out of the water. This quad, rowing at half slide, is using this sequence to create a good rhythm. By keeping a good ratio, a contrast between the drive and recovery speed, they have created a very nice rhythm. Short slide strokes facilitate the creation of the rhythm. It is very easy to be quick through the water, but very difficult to be slow and patient on the slide. 14 to 16 strokes per minute maximum is suggested rating to start this sequence. We hope you find this DVD useful. The drills that are demonstrated are standard and basic drills. If they are done with a focused and systematic approach, you should achieve a higher technical proficiency in your rowing. We know that not everybody is or was a national team athlete, but the basic principles of good rowing can be achieved by everybody.